We will hear the next presentation. The title is Study of the Dynamic Fracture of Hollow Spheres Under Compression Using the DEM. It will be presented by our colleague Jérémy Girardot. He's from the Art et Métier situated in Bordeaux, Paris Tech.
Thank you very much. As you said, we're going to talk about dynamic fracture today. I should mention that this work was done by our PhD student Arthur Corré, and the team was also composed by Jean-Benoît Cobb and Philippe Vieux. So let me first begin with a scientific context related to the dynamic effects when a rapid crack propagation occurs. Generally, we are placed in the linear elastic fracture mechanics formalism. Indeed, as the strain rates are relatively high, the behavior remains brittle. Then the energy release rate, called G, has new dependencies with the kinetic energy and the crack velocity. So if we perform the classic energy balance during a crack propagation problem, we can see that the kinetic energy appears here and depends on the crack velocity. Okay. So we have to evaluate this kinetic energy, and we have two ways to do that. The first one is an optical measurement of the velocity fields during a crack propagation. The second one is to use one. It's not possible, and generally it's not the case because we are talking about high frequencies measurements. We use a numerical simulation to do that. The other thing important also to do, which is classical in fracture mechanics, is to evaluate the most exactly as possible the created surface during the propagation. And to do that, we perform fractography, surface roughness measurements. But I'm not talking about this part today. I invite you to see this talk this afternoon to have more details about this part related to the dynamic fracture. After that, we evaluate this function, and if a quasi-permanent state is reached, we can reach and obtain this parameter, the critical energy release rate, called GDC, which is the material parameter we're looking for. Theoretical results, these well-known theoretical results from Broberg and Freund, give an example of an infinite plate under tension, and we can see that the dynamic correction factor, which is the ratio between GDC and G0, being the energy release rate without taking into account the kinetic energy, and this dynamic correction factor is plotted regarding the crack velocity. Here, the crack velocity is called V, and VR is the Rayleigh wave speed. Okay, so now we can go to the subject of this work, which is the holosphere structures. So you will see that these holospheres are quite small, sub-centimetric, and could be used in new designs for shock absorption, for example, for aeronautic applications. So very briefly, this material is made with an epoxy resin with macrometric aggregates, and the behavior appears to be elastic brittle. And a rapid crack propagation is observed, as you will see in the next slide. And the main question is, as the application is a shock absorption, we need to know how many energy are absorbed during the collapse of one sphere. This is the problem of this one. As that we we cannot initiate artificially a crack. We choose to we choose two types of loads, one quasi-static and one dynamic, in order to put two kinds, two different elastic energy in the structure before the crack propagation. So the first one was a standard compressive machine, and the second one was a dynamic compression machine built in our laboratory called the flywheel device. Very briefly, the way of it works consists of putting a high inertia energy thanks to the heavy wheel here. Then this hammer will impact the anvil, and then the compression loadings was transmitted here thanks to this buckling bar to the specimen here. The main advantage of this test is that during the compression, the strain rate is constant. And this is very important to say after that the velocity during the compression is 2 meters per second exactly during all the compressive tests. Okay. Okay. So we have two curves normally. So perhaps you can see this one here, which is the static one, and this one here, which is the dynamic one, related to the flywheel device test. So thanks to these two tests, as you can see, first we have a high dispersion, mainly coming from the process of the holospheres, but we have two tendencies, and we are about to evaluate two G10 by computing the energy and dividing by the surface. During the compressive test, we can see one major crack that propagates from the top to the bottom of the sphere, and thanks to the use of the spherical coordinates, we are able to have the crack position measurement regarding to the time. And this crack position gives us a quite linear fitting, and gives us the crack velocity. Okay, so for this test, for example, we have 153 meter per second. For your information, we also measured the Rayleigh wave speed of the material, which is about more than 1,600 meter per second. So the ratio of the crack velocity dividing by the Rayleigh wave speed is about 0.1. So now that we measure the crack velocity, we have the G10, we are now trying to evaluate the dynamic correction factor of this test. And to do that, we use the numerical simulation and a specific numerical method, the discrete element method. So I won't enter in the details of this method today, but probably you already know it. It's also called the lattice method, and use cohesive bonds between elements. And to propagate a crack is very easy, because when a crack occurs, the bonds are deleted. So numerically, it's very easy to propagate a crack. I should mention that this numerical simulation, so here you can't see very good, but this is a whole sphere made with discrete elements. This test can also be done with the finite element method one, but in our lab we are using a lot the discrete element methods, and we wanted to see if the dynamic crack propagation is quite well modeled with this method. Be careful, this simulation is a generation phase simulation, so we do not have a fracture criteria. It is the user that open artificially the cracks, because the aim of this test is to perform an energy balance. So as you can see here, with the displacement field, we open artificially a crack from the top to the bottom at certain crack velocity, then we can have the cumulative fracture energy thanks to an energy balance of such simulation. This graphic gives you the results for different crack velocities, and we can see that at a certain moment of the propagation, a quasi-stable state is reached, and you can see also the effect of the crack propagation on the cumulative fracture energy. Thanks to this stable state, we are able now to plot the same curves as Robert did for his problem, and we can see that the dynamic correction factor is quite different. Of course, we can imagine that when you put under compression a whole sphere, you have a lot of kinetic effects. And we can see here, thanks to this curve, which gives us for 0.1 ratio, a dynamic correction factor around 0.2. So it means that only 20% of the energy is restituted for the material. It means that this value is transformed using this coefficient to this value parameter, which are the GDC, and you can see that there is a huge difference. So this value seems to be closer to the real value we are looking for, which is the parameter value of the critical energy release rate. So we are going from 3.5 to 0.8. So now it's time for me to conclude. So first, in this work, we build a complete method to evaluate a parameter, the parameter critical energy release rate in holospheres. We evaluate the inertial effect thanks to a simulation built with the discrete element method. The discrete element method appears to be very useful also in dynamic fracture, which was not done yet in the literature. We also see a high distortion of the results and the non-unicity of this material parameter here. There is no unicity, and it should be. The major explanation of that is that the created surface was not well estimated. Of course, in this work, the created surface was the crack position multiplied by the width of the holospheres. And it's very naive regarding to the reality where you can have micro cracks, subsurfaces, etc., etc. So this is where we have to put some more efforts for the future in order to have a unique parameter, material parameter. And this is the end. Thank you for your attention.
Thank you very much.